Welcome to Javaism, and in this video we are going to talk about inner classes. Okay, so in the theoretical point of view, you can say inner classes is very important. And if I talk about the practical or coding part, from that side also it's important. We can say like some of the places it's required to create an inner class, and I hope like you have to aware about it. Otherwise maybe the interviewer will ask you like what are the inner classes are available and how we can create the inner classes. And some places you can say it's giving the very good performance and it's very useful also. Okay, so let's start and understand what is the inner classes, and it's a very important topics in Java only. Okay, let's start. So in Java, inner class is a class that define what within inside the another classes. It means that if some of the class is defined inside the another classes, that is called a inner class. Generally we can say a class which is defined inside the another classes, that is called a inner class. Okay, right? But in Java, inner classes or nested classes is a class that is declared inside the another or other class or interface, that is called a inner classes. That is easy. We use inner classes to logically means we can say grouping. So for example, this is the one class, inside this having another class, inside having another class, like that you can write a class. No issue. So use a inner class to logically grouping the classes and interface in a one place to be more readable and maintainable. That is the two important keyword you have to remember. Okay, readable and maintainable. So whenever you write a code with the help of the inner classes, so we are saying like those code are readable and maintainable also. You can see this 2 point, it's very important. Okay, additionally it can be access all the members of the outer classes, including the private data members and methods. So for example, we have a one inner class inside the class, and those class are trying to access the outer class, like outer class members or private methods. That is possible and he can easily access it, no issue in that. Let's go to the another slide and let's talk about what is the advantage, why we are using the nested inner classes or inner classes. Okay, so if I talk about the nested inner classes, which is represent, okay, present particular type of the relations, that is can be access all the members, data members and methods of the outer classes, including the private also. Nested classes are used to develop more readable and maintainable code because it logically group the classes and interface in one place only. Correct. Code optimization, it's required less code to write. You don't want to write a lots of the code, you can easily write it. Need of the inner classes is sometimes user need to program a class in a such a way that no other classes can access it. So for example, I want to write some of the classes which is not required to access to another classes. So what I can do, I can write those classes as a inner classes so that we can't access outside those classes. So that should be possible, and for that also you can write inner classes, no issue in that. So before include it within other classes, okay, if all the classes objects are a part of the outer object, then it is easier to insert that classes inside the outer classes. That way all the outer classes can access all the objects of the inner classes also. That is possible. Okay, let's understand what are the types of the inner classes are available in Java. So if I talk about the Java, so Java having mainly four types of the inner classes. Okay, and I hope you know about it. Okay, I hope you know about it, what are the inner classes are available inside this. Okay, so inner classes is something called member inner classes, static nested classes, local inner classes, anonymous classes. Let's see one by one. Okay, so if I talk about member inner classes, so member inner classes, it means the classes which is declared inside the another classes as a class label, that is called a member inner classes, you can say. For example, this is the outer class, and inside this class we have declared one more classes which is inner classes, so that is called a member classes, you can say. Okay, if I talk about nested classes, so in the member classes only, if you put the static keyword, that will become a static nested classes. Okay, you can just put here a static keyword. Local inner classes, it means, for example, we have a one outer classes, and inside the outer classes having a one main method, which is some method, and inside the method, if you create any of the class, so this is the outer method, but inside the method, if you create any of the class, that is called a local inner classes. Understood? So inner classes you can create inside the method also, that is also possible. Anonymous inner classes is very famous, very useful, and might be you can see it so many places we have used it. Okay, so what is the anonymous? So anonymous means like right now in the Java 1.8, so we are not providing the anonymous implemented classes. We are going with now a lambda expression or method reference. So method reference and lambda expressions are replace this concept, which is anonymous inner classes, you can say. Okay, let's see what is the anonymous inner classes. So this is the special type of the inner classes that does not have the name. It's typically used when you need to be defined our classes on the fly without explicitly creating a separate classes. Anonymous inner classes are declared and instantiated at the same time. They can be used for implementing interface or extending the classes. So they are only using for implementing the what? Interface, you can see here. So providing a implementations of the interfaces, we are using the anonymous classes. Okay, and if you see here, for example, we have a one outer classes and we have a one method also. Inside the method, we want to implement a runnable, and runnable is a one interface which is available in a thread. We have learned the thread, so that time we have seen thread is a runnable is a one of the interface, which is functional interface, and we can provide or implement this interface directly with the anonymous inner classes. Anonymous classes directly we can provide the implementation with the help of lambda expression, functional interface, method reference. So that is possible. So it's one of the concept which is anonymous inner classes, we can do it. Okay, so this is the anonymous inner classes. So I hope guys you understood what is the use and how you can use the inner classes and how it's important. Okay, you don't want to focus lots of that. Okay, because in rare case we are using the inner classes, not every day, because if you think about the Java 1.8 features, he come up with the lambda expression, method reference, so they are replace those technology, they replace those things. Whatever we are doing inside the inner classes, we can do easily with the help of the lambda expression or method difference. So not required all those things. Okay guys, understood? Thank you so much. Please like and subscribe my video. Thank you so much.